To set up your own Gmail account, just go to gmail.com, and on the top right of the screen, go ahead and click on Create an Account. And you're going to want to go ahead and fill in all this information. This last option here will let Google use your account information to do plus ones and ads and so forth. You can include that or not. Click on Next Step, and you'll see your email in the top corner, and it'll say you're all set, and you can go ahead and click on Continue to Gmail. Now that you have your Gmail account, the next step is going to be to go ahead and create an account for your child. In order to do that, you need to log out of your Gmail account and go ahead and create another account. Once you've entered all your child's information and you get to the birthday field, I'd recommend putting in your birthday again. Again, this is your second account that you're letting your child use. Gmail doesn't allow children under the age of 13 to have their own Gmail account. Therefore, this is technically your account that your child will view on occasion. Again, there's no need for a mobile phone or any current email address for these accounts. And you can fill in the basic information here. And when you're putting your child's information in, I recommend uncheck Google's ability to use the account information for their Google Plus social media site. Click on Next. And now you have a new account that your child can use. Now, once you're in your child's account, there are a few settings you're going to want to adjust for that child. And that's the little gearbox here. If you click on that, and then click on the word settings, you'll have all kinds of options you can adjust. The one setting I'd recommend adjusting under the General tab is this one that says Browser Connection. And I would go ahead and check Always Use HTTPS. That just makes it a more secure environment when you do your emails. Then I go ahead and adjust the chat settings. Depending on what you prefer, you can leave chat on or off. I recommend for younger children to turn chat off. If you're going to leave chat on, you're probably going to want to come down here and check that only allow people I've explicitly approved to chat with me and to see when I'm online. You can also go over here to web clips and uncheck the option that says show my web clips above the inbox. That'll just keep some unnecessary stuff from showing up on the inbox. And then finally, you can go under the accounts and import section, and you can add another account here. And what this is going to do is allow you to grant access to your account, so you'll be able to see any emails that come into this account, which you know that your child is also seeing. So you want to enter the account name that you just created for yourself or that you already have and click on the Next Step button. And it explains it's going to send an email to you. Go ahead and do that. And then you're going to need to go ahead and log out and log back in to the account that you just created for yourself in order to verify. And to do that, you can click on your little picture thing there, click on Sign Out, enter your account information, sign back into the account you made, open up the email you just got, and click on the link to accept the request. And now you should be able to view and send messages on behalf of your child. Now that you've been granted access to your child's account, you can go back under settings for your account, and you can go to the accounts and import option, and you can add a POP3 mail account you own. So now we're going to add our child's account. Click on Next Step and enter the password for our child. I like to label the incoming messages so I know that they're being sent to my child. And click on Add Account. And then it's going to ask if you also want to be able to send mail as that account. And if you'd like to, you can, or you can change it later. If you do want to send as that account, you probably want to uncheck this Treat as an Alias option. Click Next, then click Send Verification. At this point, it'll send an email to your child's account, and you can click a link right within the email, so you can actually close this window, and then log back out, log back in as your child. You can skip this information, don't need to mess with it. And you should see a confirmation asking to confirm the request that you just made. And you click that link right in the middle. And now you can also send as mail for them. Now that your child's email account is set up so that everything they receive gets forwarded to you, if you want, you can add one more filter to the account that will send everything your child sends to anybody else a copy to you. To do that, the first thing you need to do is set yourself up as a forwarding option. To do that, you click on the Forwarding and POPI Map tab, click on Add a Forwarding Address, and of course, enter your address. Go ahead and click Next, and then you can confirm, and then you'll get an email, and you'll have to log back out, log into your email address, click on the confirmation link in order to confirm it. You'll see a confirmation email. Click on the link in that email, and now your child can forward to you. Log back out. Log back in as your child. Go back into the settings and click on the filters tab this time. And now we're going to create a new filter that takes every email your child sends and forwards a copy to you. Click Create Filter with this search. Click on Forward It To, pick your address, and Create Filter. And now it's set up so that every email your child sends to anybody else automatically gets sent to you. Let's go ahead and go back in the inbox and compose an email just to check it out. So now we send ourselves an email. Of course, we can see it. Log back out. Log back in as yourself. And there you'll see the email your child just sent. Now that every email your child sends is being copied to you, you want to add a label to all the emails that come in from your child. Otherwise, you won't know when you're receiving an actual email from your child versus an email your child is sending to someone else. To do that, you have to go under settings again, and you have to create a filter. So you'll click on the filters tab. You'll click create a new filter. Anything coming from your child that's not addressed to you. And to do that, you put a minus sign and then your email address. Click on Create Filter with this search. Click on Apply the Label. Pick the name of your child's email address as the label and click Create Filter. And now, everything your child sends that's not addressed to you will come across to you with the label with their email address attached to it. And now that your email account is set up and your child's email account is set up and it's all working properly, you can go ahead and give your children access to the account. At that point, you have a couple options. If you want to get very specific about it, you would set up the email account using an email agent like Outlook or Outlook Express or Apple's mail program, and set it up so that it accesses this Gmail account. You put in the password once, they'll never know what it is. The only way they'll get and send their email is from the computer. You can also set up your iPods, your iPhones, your iPads the same way. Or if you want to trust your child to have their own email account online and access it through Gmail, you can do that, but they will need the password. And they will be able to make changes to any of these settings. So again, if you trust your child, you could let them make those changes. If not, you're going to want to have them use an email client of some sort that accesses the email and that you put the password in. Hopefully that helps you out and you get your children set up and running on email.